We are under the lights as the show gets you ready for another edition of Major League Baseball. A good matchup here for you tonight between the Houston Astros and the Tampa Bay Rays. Digging in now, George Springer. He'll get us started in this one under the lights. Now the 1-1 pitch. And this is taken for a called third strike as the leadoff man is set down to open up the ball game.
Gotta check it.
So the bases are empty with one man gone.
And that'll bring up Alex Bregman.
1-2 now as that one's fouled off. One out, nobody on. And he takes strike three called, and it's a pair of punch outs that begin the ball game.
That is hurt.
Now the Astros designated hitter Michael Brantley will attempt to put the ball in play for a change here with the first two guys going down on strikes to start the inning. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Meadows moving back, still ranging back. See you later. Over the wall, a home run. Late now, Yuli Gurriel. Good change up in the dirt, strike three. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over. Stepping into the box, Yandy Diaz. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first. This is popped up. Knee high, he barehands it. It's there, and he's out. Up next for the Rays, Brandon Lau. He'll get to take his first cuts here. Bases are empty, one man out. Fastball just inside. Fouled away. Two-two pitch is a fastball high, so it runs full 3-2.
No pitcher likes to take the count to 3-2, especially when...
Now he spins on one here and drives it to deep right field. Reddick is back to the warning track, and he's able to put it away for the second out. Joe Wendell digs in now. No one aboard for him, and two gone here in the first. The 1-1 home. Waved at and missed for the third out. Not much of a chance at hitting that one, and the inning is over. Second inning set to go, and next will be a speed threat in the form of outfielder Kyle Tucker. The 1-1. Lifted in the air to center field. Kiermaier giving chase. He gets to it and makes the catch for the first out. So the base is empty here with one away. And ambling over to the batter's box is Carlos Correa. The 2-1 home. Drilled to the right side. And a backhanded reach at first, but he can't flag it down. In now, Josh Reddick. One ball and two strikes to count. And another foul ball. To two balls and two strikes now.
Hey, he threw that pitch with a purpose to get a double play. Good job to let it go by, though, as a hitter.
Oh, and this is swung on and missed. Four strikeouts already, and that's out number two.
Batting it.
Striding in for Houston, Aledmys Diaz. He takes his first cuts in this one with a man at first and two away. Pulled high in the air out to left field. Margo's under it. And the inning is over. Last half of the second set to go. And digging in is the outfielder, Austin Meadows. The 2-1 home. It was taken, ball three. Lifted in the air to straightaway center. On the move is Springer. He gets there to make the play for the first out of the inning. To the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Yoshi Tsutsugo, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. The 1-1 home. One out, nobody on. Two and two. Swing and a miss on the changeup, and there are two gone. So bases are empty here with two gone. And up next will be Willie Adames. Slider can't find the zone here, and he's behind now 3-1.
Three ball count right now. This looks like the best chance of getting a base runner on so far.
Strike two called, and it's full 3-2. Filthy changeup that time, but he's able to make contact, and he'll get another chance. Too close for comfort, and he did a good job just to make contact. Fly ball out to straightaway right field. Reddick is going to have room out there as he puts this away to retire the side. Top of the third set to get underway. And up next, the former Angel Martin Maldonado. The 1-2. Heading out towards shallow right. Meadows has it, and there's one away. Next up for the Stros, George Springer, 0-1 here in the early going. Bases are empty, one man out. He likely had ball four that time, but couldn't hold back on the swing, so that moves the count to 3-2 now. Just staying alive, putting together a really good at-bat here. And he fouls this one off. The 3-2 one more time. Changed up on him as this is grounded to second. Right to him. Throw gets him, two down. Now at the plate, Alex Bregman. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, and they froze him on a good changeup. Tough one. If you got good arm action.
Ouch, that one hit him. So runner at first here with two gone in the inning. And Michael Brantley settles in to hit at the plate. The 1-2. Right side. Oh, a diving effort as it's off his glove. But they'll still manage to get the out on the force, and with that fine play, the inning comes to an end. Leading off the inning, Kevin Kiermaier, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. The 1-1 home. Sent on the ground out to second. Diaz picks it up, and that's the first down. So one away here with the bases empty. And that'll bring up the versatile center fielder, Manuel Margot. And he misses ball four. So a runner at first with one man gone. And that'll bring up the catcher, Mike Zunino. Now a throw over and a dive, but he's back in. Now the 3-2 pitch is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. Digging in, Yandy Diaz.
The first baseman, number two,
Margot Yandy leads off first with a pair of outs in the inning. There goes Margot. Lifted into the air to shallow center. Correa ranging into the outfield, and the Rays are in the hit column. But it's offline, so the run will score.
Now batting, number 8.
To the plate now, Brandon Lau. Change up just off the black, and it's 2-1. Left side, but well fouled. Swing and a ground ball to third. Bregman has it. On to the first baseman, Gurriel, and that will end the inning. All set for the start of the inning, and digging in to bat next, the Cuban import, Yuli Gurriel. The 1-1. Now that ball's hit well, deep down the left field line, headed toward the foul pole. And he's going to have room to put this one away, and that's the first out. Into the box now, Kyle Tucker. He flew out in his last at-bat. One run, two hits. No errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. And it's fouled away. Ground ball right side, reined in, and the off-balance throw beats him at first, and that's a tough play. So bases are empty here with two gone, and the former number one overall pick in American League Rookie of the Year, Carlos Correa, bats next. Inside and low, 2-1. One run, two hits, no errors in the ballgame for the Astros to this point. Down the third baseline. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Kiermaier is under this one, and he will make the catch, so that'll do it. Ready to go in the bottom of the fourth, and set to go is the third baseman, Joey Wendell. Now the 1-1 pitch is a changeup that's looked at for a ball. This is on the ground over to first, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Austin Meadows. So far 0-for-1 with a flyout. Not much behind this, as this ball is looped over toward first. But this will be taken easily at first, and there are two gone.
The designated hitter.
To the plate now is the designated hitter, Yoshi Tsutsugo. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Yeah, but it was a good changeup, Matty. Good arm action on that pitch. Look for him to try and stay back a little bit more. Let the ball get a little deeper. Don't be shocked if this pitcher tries to rush a heater right here.
Standing in now, Willy Adames. A ball and two strikes to the Rays shortstop. And this is sliced foul into the stands in right, out of play.
He was absolutely all over that fastball. Have to find a way to keep that fair.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. So here's Josh Reddick looking to put the ball in play here. He went down on strikes in his first at bat.
Sometimes you just got to tip your cap to the guy on the mound. He's getting paid to try and get you out as well. Anytime it gets up there north of 7-8 pitch ABs, sometimes it just comes down to pure execution. Let's see if he makes the adjustment right here.
Stepping in, Aledmys Diaz comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. A swing and a miss there. 2-2.
Really feels like he's just on cruise control out there on the mound right now.
Boy, this is a tight one. You kind of get the feeling like the next team that scores is going to win this one.
Throw on to first, two gone. Now at the plate, Martin Maldonado flied out in his first at bat, so make him 0 for 1 so far. The 2-1 is a sinker that dips below the zone for a ball.
Team's been struggling on offense. Let your D work for you right here. Pound the zone.
Hit on the ground to short. Adames scoops it up. Throw to first in plenty of time, and the side is retired. Ready to go for the last half of the inning, and that means Kevin Kiermaier will hit next. And it's a ball and two strikes to Kiermaier now. Line shot to first, and there's one away. Digging in, Manuel Margot. He scored after reaching on a walk in his first at bat. Here now the 2-2. Is looked at for ball three. On deck, the big bat of Mike Zunino. Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away.
Now batter.
So here's Mike Zunino. He was a strikeout victim in his first try. In front of the changeup, and he can't keep it fair. Two strikes on him now. The 1-2 is taken for ball two. This one's outside, quite a bit off the plate that time. Yandy Diaz would be next. In the air now out to left field. Chasing after it is Tucker. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. Top half of the sixth about to get started, and standing in is the veteran outfielder, George Springer. Looking to fade his first walk. Here it comes. Line toward right center. He leaps, but he can't get it. It's down for extra bases. And he'll pull into second here with nobody out. Into the box now, Alex Bregman. Keeping it down here as it's 2-1. In the dirt here, but it won't skip away far enough for the runner to advance. Tried to get him with the cutter, but it's a full count, 3-2.
Not a time to fool around right now on a 3-2 count with the middle part of the order coming up. Expect a good pitch to swing at.
Now a cut fastball, and this is over but low. It's ball four.
Now batting.
And here's the left-handed hitting Michael Brantley. Set. Here comes the 1-1.
Great chance right here as a hitter to be really aggressive. With two guys already on, pretty good shot. He's going to get a challenge pitch right here.
Grounded down the third baseline, but this will wind up a foul ball. 2-2. Had to sit back on the changeup, and he did a good job to get the bat on that one. Double play ball to second. 4-6-3, and they turn the double play. So here's Yuli Gurriel, runner in scoring position with two gone. The 1-1. Swing and a miss. That one tied him up. Two outs here with a runner at third. Popped him up. Diaz
is there, and he puts this one away for the third out. So a great job there of working out a potential trouble.
Bottom of the sixth inning now, and here comes the first baseman, Yandy Diaz.
The 1-2
is looked at for ball number two.
Popped up.
And there's one down now. Striding in, Brandon Lau. He was a ground out victim last time up. One out, nobody on. And it's two balls and two strikes now. Fouled off.
Not surprised he's late on a heater right there. Just saw an off speed pitch, wanted to stay back a little bit too long.
And that misses there, so he runs the count full now.
3-2 counts are usually a time to challenge the hitter, but I think he'll be careful here.
Oh, hang on now. This ball is deep down the line and right. It looks to have the distance, and it's fair, a home run.
Well, people always wonder why some players make so much money, and there's your answer. The great ones find a way to rise to the occasion in the postseason, and he did right there.
Cionel Pérez, 5'11" left-handed reliever, enters to take over on the mound now. Into the box, Joey Wendell. Line drive to left, and that's in for a base hit. Make it a 1-for-3 game so far. At the plate now, Austin Meadows changes up on him, but that's in the dirt for a ball. Throw over to first, but the runner's back easily. The 2-1 home. Pitch is a cold strike. The throw. And it's far too late as he steals second with ease. Set. Here's the 2-2. Hit hard to the right side. And the off-balance throw gets him. Nice play for the out. Striding forward now is the DH, Yoshitsu Tsugo. 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far. Looking to keep this a one-run game, the pitch. Changeup gets him out in front for strike two.
That's a really nice thing about pitching with the base open. You can work out of the strike zone a little bit more and try to get a guy to chase your pitch just like that one.
Full count, 3 balls and 2 strikes to the Rays DH. Payoff pitch on its way.
A swing and a shot hit down the corner. And that's going to wind up hooking just a bit foul, so a missed opportunity there. He's set. The 3-2. A shot down the first baseline. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over.
Colin Poche is on to pitch from the bullpen now to start inning number 7.
Number 38.
Striding into the box, Kyle Tucker. Already the beginning of the 7th inning here, as this game has had a very brisk pace to it so far.
This thing's far from over, even though we're moving into the back end of this game. Only down by one. All they need to do is get this leadoff guy, and they're an extra base hit away from tying this thing up.
Here he comes on a ball and 2 strikes. Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. The 2-2 one more time. Good swing, but a late one as it's fouled off to the left. And again, he's unable to keep it fair, but he's putting together quite a battle at the plate. A
another 2-2 offering. And he can only battle for so long as he's finally set down here after an 8-pitch at-bat. Stepping into the box, Carlos Correa. It was a flyout for him in his last trip. A little behind on that swing, and now he'll try to shorten up maybe and protect the plate. The 1-2. Misses, ball two. We're in the seventh inning now of a pitcher's duel. 2-1 our score. And he strikes him out as well. So make it back-to-back punch outs here to the first two men he faces out of the bullpen. Hit on the ground to third. Fielded cleanly. Throw in time, and the side is retired. Brad Peacock gets the call from the pen to take over on the mound and start the home seventh. Last half of the seventh here, and stepping up as the shortstop, Willie Adames. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. And he looks at one in there, 1-2.
The count is 1-2.
Ball. Breaking ball that time that misses out of the zone. And a good bite to that slider as he swings through it for the first out of the inning. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. Head-to-head matchups with Brad Peacock. He's 0 for 4. Full count to the Rays center fielder. Sliced hard on the ground. And that's the second out. And that'll bring up Manuel Margot. He was sent packing on strikes in his last trip. Bases are empty here with two men out. Oh, got him looking at the two-seamer, and that'll end it. Diego Castillo has been summoned from the bullpen as he'll do so to start the eighth.
Number 63, Diego.
Coming to the plate now, Aledmys Diaz. He's 0 for 2 thus far in this one. Into the windup, ready with the payoff pitch. Line to the right side, but a foul ball. Oh, and that runs in and gets him. So now the potential tying run is aboard to lead off the inning. Time called here, as with the potential tying run aboard, they'll make the move to get a little more speed out there. At the plate, Martin Maldonado. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. Hit hard to third, and a reach with the backhand, but he comes up empty as that gets by him. Number 31 will come on now and pinch run here. So now to the plate, George Springer. In the dirt and block behind the plate. And a nice job to keep the runners at bay as the count moves to 2-2. Hit on the ground to third. And the throw to first will take care of him, but it comes at a cost as the tying run is in to score. Runner at second, one away, and that'll bring up the LSU product, Alex Bregman. He's set. Here comes the 1-1. Slider finds the zone for a strike. Swing and a miss, and they'll dodge a major bullet that time. Two away. Now to the plate, Michael Brantley. It's his job to get something into the outfield and give that go-ahead run a chance to score from second. And he can't catch the corner here, so he's behind 3-1.
When you're playing close games like this, base runners mean everything, so he can ill afford to start giving away free passes.
Scooped up, On to first, and this will remain a tie ball game as the inning is over. Andre Scrub is on to pitch out of the bullpen in the bottom half of the eighth.
Number 70, Andre Scrub.
Bottom of inning number 8 set to go, and that'll bring up the catcher Mike Zunino. Now the 1-1 pitch misses off the plate. Left side of the infield into the shift. Reined in. Throw on to first in time, one away. And that will bring in Yandy Diaz. He's working on a 1-for-3 thus far. Now the 2-1. And this runs inside, and that looked like it got him pretty good. Digging in and looking for more, Brandon Lau. It was a solo shot for him in his last at-bat.
We all know this guy's a real good fastball hitter. We saw how far he could hit one. He got a fastball that he liked, and he turned that thing around, and it got out of here in a hurry.
Now here's a line drive, and this is going to get down for extra bases. And they'll have runners at second and third following the one-out double. Stepping in now, Joey Wendell. Swung on and missed 3-2.
Well, this is a strikeout situation, but it's also a ground ball situation. I expect we'll see a lot of pitches down in the zone trying to prevent the hitter from getting the ball up in the air.
And he misses with it, ball four, so that'll load the bases, and now he's really going to need to get a ground ball. The count now at 2-2. Ready now. Two strike pitch on its way. Oh, this is hit to third. Will it be two? To second for one. Over to Gurriel for an inning ending double play. Chaz Rowe will be on the mound to start the ninth inning, and his job will be keeping the ball game tied until the bottom half. All set to start the ninth in this one, and next to bat will be the first baseman, Yuli Gurriel. The 1-2 is swung on and missed. He got him. At the plate, Kyle Tucker. He was punched out looking at strike three last time through.
Yeah, Matty, and hopefully he got it out of his system. Especially now, he's got a bear down. He gets the two strikes in this spot, has to put the ball in play.
Ball taken there, 2-1 now. Now the pitch. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. Legs churning, he's headed for second. And he's not stopping, he wants three. And he'll make it to third base safely with only one out as the go-ahead run. To the plate now, Carlos Correa. And that misses, 2-1. Liner towards second. And a reach to his backhand side at second, but this finds a way by. And the run is going to score from third as they've taken the lead here in the ninth.
Next to the outfield, the right fielder, Josh Reddick.
Into the box now, Josh Reddick. Fouled away. Lifted down the line and left. Heading after it is Margot, and this will fall, but it's a foul ball. Again, a 1-2. And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight. Ready now, Miles Straw. A 1-1 count. Here's the pitch. Sent on the ground out to second. Throw to second for the force out, and the side is retired. Ryan Pressly takes the ball now in inning number 9, looking to close the door. All set for the bottom of the ninth. And digging in is the rookie designated hitter, Yoshi Tsutsugo. And a good spot for that pitch is it's chopped foul. The 1-2. This is popped up. Strong is there for it. One down. Striding in once again, Willy Adames. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. The 2-2 gets him looking up around the letters. So here's Kevin Kiermaier. He was retired via the ground ball last time up.
Yeah, I understand that, Matty, but this guy's got burner wheels down the first baseline. I don't think he even concerns himself with that. He has to put it on the ground. That's part of what makes him successful.
Tampa down to their final strike in this one. Really pulled that one across as the slider misses well inside.
The classic back foot slider right there with 2 strikes. Usually gets a ton of swing and misses. Nice layoff right there. Fight for another pitch.
Full count now. Has them down to their final strike. Here it comes. And this ball swung on and hit to center field. And this should do it. He's got it. And the Astros are going to take home field advantage right back. They win game 3 to go up 2-1 as this one is over.
Well, that's just a great job of battling on the road. They fought all the way to the end, took the lead in the top of the ninth, and secured the W in the bottom half. That's a great team win.
This one, definitely a low-scoring affair as we get one last look at our final line score. Heroes are made in the postseason, and he was at least the hero in this one. He's our Topps player of the game.
Yeah, no time like the postseason to come through and lift your team to victory. He was certainly a big factor here, and it was pretty cool to see.
Three to two, the finish in tonight's game. The Astros take a 2-1 advantage in this division series. Andre Scrub gets the W on the mound. So that's a wrap here tonight. For Mark DeRosa, Dan Plesac, and Heidi Watney, this is Matt Vasgersian. You've been watching MLB The Show. For more, find us on Twitter at MLB The Show.
Fans, our final line score tonight. First for the victorious Astros. 3 runs, 6 hits, no errors. They left 5 men on base. For the Rays, 2 runs on 5 hits, no errors. They left 6 men on base.